of the best brains we have put up this show together for all our proud parents on this very special day, the Cultural Day Ballad of Seasons. So on this occasion, with the divine presence of His Holiness Jagat Guru Padma Bhushan Sri 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 Dr. Balagangadharanath Mahaswamiji, Sri 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 Dr. Nirmalanandanath Mahaswamiji, Sri Sri Dr. Prakashnath Swamiji, Managing Director and BGS Group of Institution. I would first like to welcome our eminent chief guest, Sir M.K. Joshi, who is presently the Director of Academy for Creative Teaching. Sir M.K. Joshi has over 50 years of experience as a teacher. He has worked in Kendriya Vidyalaya School, New Delhi, as a teacher and a principal, and has been associated with the opening of a dozen schools of KVS. He not only helps tribal schools, but also helps in the development of similar institutions. He has also been associated with Edupedia in the opening of preschools and tradition schools and the world body called SR Rao Memorial, a foundation for archaeology, art and culture. His work towards the discovery of Dwarka, especially the discovery of Krishna Palace, is noteworthy. Besides this, he is presently working as a consultant to over 85 educational institutions. Sir, we thank you for gracing us with your presence. We are privileged to have you amongst us today. I would also like to welcome our cabinet director, Sri Ayappan Nair, our principal, Ms. Shrikala G. Kumar, our vice principal, Ms. Savita Suvarna, our headmistress, Ms. Pushpa Hegde, and our coordinator, Ms. Shravani Sen Gupta. Next, I would like to welcome all our parents who can feast their eyes today on a variety of dance, drama, and music. I would also like to welcome our ever supportive teachers and all my dear friends who are eagerly waiting to showcase their programs to you. Now, I request our beloved Academy Director, sir, to felicitate our chief guest with a beautiful bouquet of flowers.
spring to winter. Spring is blooming. The flowers grow. It rains a lot and melts the snow.
Hey, did you guys lunch? Is this one for the ballad of seasons?
Well, yes.
Good morning, Suprabhat, Vanakkam, and Subhamachari to Vanakkam visit here. Hold on, Pushan, good morning, ready. Anyway, warm good morning to one and all present here.
The ballad of seasons is a metaphor in itself. Nature is a manifestation of God.
Change is the most dynamic feature of nature. It changes without pain, no change, and without change, no growth, and hope meets its end. It teaches mankind the lesson of peace, innocence, hope, and faith in the glory of God. This is a peace welcome from the bottom of our heart for this program, brought to you by
the amazing 5E,
the brilliant minds of class 5B.
Hey, who is it there?
Thank you. But we reached the bird
century, he saw first many dogs like Doberman, Greyhounds and many other big dogs. Then he also saw some birds like crane, swan, bulbul, parrots, parakeets, etc. Then it was time for us to go on an amazing and bumpy tractor ride. We finished a big rounded tractor ride and then it was time for us to go to the bonsai garden. We all got very excited when it was time for us to go to the bonsai garden because it was the most exciting part of the field trip. So we stood in line and visited the bonsai garden. Then we saw many different plants and pots and we also saw some very white house-like structures. We entered a white house-like structure and saw that many fans were connected to the walls. It was so cool compared to the temperature outside. So after that, when we exited the bonsai garden, we went and we saw that there were many other different things. Some of the things were like we were playing in the playground and many other things. Then it was time for us to eat our lunch. We played more in that. We played in banyan trees and we enjoyed it so much. Oh, how fun it was. Then it was time for all of us to go back and eat our lunch. After the lunch, we played more in banyan trees. I was so sad because we were leaving our wonderful Bhagyalakshmi farm. It was so fun staying there, so I did not feel like leaving that area. But all good things come to an end. So I guess it was time for us to all leave. So we ate our snack quickly and boarded our respective buses. This was a literally amazing field trip. I hope we have more amazing field trips in the next few years of BGS school. This is me, Mala from Class 5K. Thank you.
The stage is offense. Thank you. Are around the corner.
Oh wow! Hey Amrita,
The pigeon
and the
rock
massage
attack. should see how much effort the students and the teachers have put in and exhibit their talents. Credit goes to the people who are involved in it. And naturally, parents are eager to know how their children are performing, what they expect from the school, whether we are on the right track. These are the questions do arise as parents to us. Today, I would like to focus only on the parents. On some other day, I can talk to students. For having moved to different places and having learned the situations in different places, I can give you glimpses of the schools in India and abroad. And you can derive your own way how we are progressing. India, there is a tremendous explosion of knowledge. Hundreds of thousands of schools are coming all over the parts of India. And the picture of the schools which I narrate can give you a comparison. Near Delhi, about 150 kilometers back away, I went to a school. School had 1200 children. The school was built in the memory of a soldier, Captain Ashok, who died in the Srinagar ambush. I had a meeting with the parents. One of the parents asked me, why should you have a uniform for the students? It was amazing. Parents in Bangalore demand something, but parents in that say, why should you have a uniform? I asked why. He said, in my life, as a parent, only 3 days in a year, I wear my shirt. When I go to field, when I work, I don't wear. Why my children should wear? It's a question for me to think over. I went to a place, the organizers wanted to have a school, a rich organizers, with all facilities. Suggested them, but the organizer told, this school is meant for those children. We give admission to those children only on one condition. Father or mother are criminally convicted. Can you think of an institute that it wants to give education to the students where the father and mother, due to the criminal activity, they have been sent to jail, they are denied further of the education? Variety of the things you can see. I have a world body associated with that. It is called DIDAC. Under the United Nations, we have different schools in the world. When they meet here, in Bangalore, I conducted two places. I was amazed to see, in Bangladesh, schools on the boat, 650 to 700 boats are there. Each boat had only 2 or 3 students. The school is run on that. The school from Maldives, Malay what we call, 1400 islands are there. Only 300 islands are active. In each island, you may be having 75 to 100 students. But the government has provided facility to all. Here itself in Bangalore, near to Mysore, I conduct a school for the tribal people. I was amazed to see when we started the school there, children had not eaten rice, only ragi mudde. Very peculiar incident I would like to tell. It is meant for the tribal. In the class, the child by turn has to give food, distribute food to the children, their fellow seater. Once his brother wanted to come and to the school and see how it runs. There were 40 students. That rice budde was prepared and it was distributed. The boy in charge had made 39 laddus, gave it to all students. The 40th was divided by two, one for himself and one for the brother who had brought him to the place. These are the lovely experiences we come across. As a parent, when you have admitted your children, forget what these children are going to do. Do not compare with your neighbor, neighbor's child. Even a small thing is a dangerous thing. I do not know who made the rule that 35 is the passing mark. 80% majority will get. No. Even the smallest thing we came across, I have a wide spectrum of views. In Odisha, when I used to go to the schools, I used to casually ask the children, what do you want to become? One girl told, I want to become actress. I looked at her with my angle, how Hema Malini looks, how Sridevi looks, or the celebrities look. The child did not have that look at all. But after 10 years, I saw a Oriya film. The same girl was acting in a film. I contacted this school. Yes, they are. When I talk of Bihar, you have a different opinion. I went to a school in Bihar. I asked, what do you want to become? I said, IAS officer. After 10, 15 years, I find, really he has completed the IAS, holding the position. So you will be disappointed if you think your child is the only one who can succeed. Many are there. There is a scope for all. No competition is required. And you won't. I never knew when I go around the places. In arts, they were. In many things, even you may not be doing, or if you have not come across. I saw in India there is a school called mining school, Dhanbad. I never knew. A laundryman boy, when I was in the northeast, father brought him, the laundryman boy, and the boy was studying in 4th standard. I asked him, what do you want to become? Sir, I want to go to Dhanbad school. I never heard Dhanbad school. I made inquiry, it is a mining school, oldest mining school in India, done by Britishers. Many of the Biharis, lower cadre, want to put their children in the Dhanbad. Many a time I am called for alumni, old students association, normally for 25 years when I complete. I mean, different places I go and talk. When the children at some point find, out of 25, more than 20 have become very successful, occupied all places. And it is so, not in one school, in hundreds and many schools in India and abroad. If your boy picks up a good manner, you have given them a good sanskar. If the boy cares for all, you have given them sanskar. Unfortunately, the present institutes where we see in Bangalore and other places, we are misled by the infrastructure, we are misled by the people who are working. Lot of good infrastructure, very qualified teachers are there, lot of results also they will come, get. But emotions lacking, we lack emotion, we don't respect the elders. Elders' view is respect. They say, what do you know? I know better. My teacher has told. The life is complete when you are have developed the emotions. In your spare time, I request the parent, if you are accessible to internet, go to the YouTube, see the founder Alibaba, Jack Ma, listen to him and see the wonder of it. So only I request you, you have given the child to the school, teachers are taking, management is taking care of them. Forget what is their performance. The end product is always going to be very good. I am very happy. The listening crowd is there. Attention, you are listening. My purpose of coming all the way here is solved. Many a time I feel whenever the institute comes, invites me, at least I have to spend about 4 to 5 hours a day to engage with the institute. In a year, only on 50 to 70 days I am found in Bangalore. The rest of the places I have been moving on to the village, this, that, that. So I am quite satisfied with the school and the management here. I hope after 10 years I will come back and find out from the school how these children of 5th have fared in their life. Thank you for giving me this opportunity. May God bless you all. Carry happy moments. Thank you.
For enriching us with your valuable thoughts. As I was mentioning that every season has its own character and charm. But unfortunately, due to human intervention in nature, the seasons are losing their beauty and we are losing our health. One of the main causes for it is the plastic pollution, which is grabbing the earth gradually, leaving it a bare land. This year we have taken up a project to reduce
day-to-day life. The name of the project is Beat Plastic Pollution. In this project, our students did many activities. They participated in many activities, including singing a song, Plastic Not Fantastic. This song is a brainchild of BGS NPS. It has been written here and composed with a beautiful tune in our campus only. Now I request our students of class 5 to present the song before you.